And in this screencast, I'm going to show you one of the easiest ways to write a program using VBA. And in order to do that, we need to be on the Developer tab. And what we're going to do is we're going to make a macro. And we're going to record the keystrokes that I make, save it as a program, and then we can use it anytime we want to. What we want to do here is we want to take our T data and make this column into 1 over T, and we want to take our D data and square it. Let's begin. The first thing that comes up is something that asks us to name this macro, and I'm just going to call it TD. You can put in a shortcut key, you can describe it, you can store the macro other places, but right now we're going to say this workbook, and then we'll say OK. And now the VBA is recording every keystroke that I do. So here I want it to equal 1 divided by the temperature, and I want this to equal D squared. And now I'm going to use this simple fill, double clicking over on the right here, and that fills it in. That's all that we want to do here. So up here we stop recording. Now let's take a look at what we've created. We can do one of two things. We can either go click over here to Visual Basic, but what I usually do is toggle back and forth using Alt F11. So I go Alt F11, and over here under Modules is our macro. So we click on Module 1, and what we find is a program that's been written using the keystrokes that we had. And if you notice this screen, that's a comment that just gives us the name. Let's go back and run it again. So let's get rid of that. And now we click on macros because it's already there, and we run it, and it does it automatically. Other things that we can do with this macro, instead of going to macros, you can use Alt F8. But the easiest thing to do to be able to run any program from the spreadsheet is to insert some kind of shape, any kind of shape you want. Let's do a happy face right here. If we right-click on this, you see that it says Assign Macro. We take this macro and assign it to this button. So that means now, anytime we click on this button, the macro will automatically run.